the worst streamer on the internet, Battery H.
You're right. I'm so bad I forgot to pop in the right things. Good evening, everybody. Hey, I'm Battery H. Welcome to 100 Days of Gaming. Let's see if I've got... Okay, yeah, welcome to 100 Days of Gaming. I've been waiting for this for weeks now. It's time to get things started. We stream here for Extra Life, and Extra Life is a charity that raises money for over 700... Yeah, 170, that's the one. 170 hospitals in the United States and Canada that help children as part of the Children's Miracle Network. We're going to get this right if it kills me today. I'm going to be streaming over the next 100 days, some in the evenings, sometimes in the mornings, sometimes in the afternoons. And we're going to be playing a whole host of games in hopes that we can get me much, much closer to my goal of $1,337. We're at $470 right now. The money we're raising goes to Children's Hospital of New Orleans. 100% goes to help the kids. Not a penny goes to overhead. Not a penny goes to staff parties or paying administrators. It all goes towards the kids. It's a great organization. And frankly, every dollar counts. I don't care if you can only donate a dollar. If you can donate a dollar, I'm asking that you do. We're going to have a lot of fun over the next 100 days. We're going to be playing a whole host of stuff, like I said. We've got The Walking Dead Seasons 1 and 2. We're starting with Walking Dead tonight. Fallout 4, when the Nuka World hits. I'm planning on Mafia 3, Civilization 6, and some good stuff that... I've got thrown in there in addition to things like American Truck Sim. Every Sunday, we're going to continue our trucking adventures. Fallout 4 stuff with World of Warships, Heroes of the Storm, Rocket League. Monday Madness Nights will continue to be things that aggravate me. We've got wonderful games like Galactic Civilizations 3, Cook Serve Delicious, Prison Architect, Plague Incorporated Evolved. All kinds of fun stuff, and I've got some of these games are brand new to me. Like tonight, we're starting off with Walking Dead. I don't know if I mentioned Mafia 3 when it comes out. I'm hoping that I'll be able to get they don't have a release date for Planet Coaster when that releases as well. So I hope you stick around. I'm gonna start calling up The Walking Dead. While I do, I also want to say if you've enjoyed what you see today. What did I want? That? I don't want to do that. I want to launch The Walking Dead. If you enjoy what you see today, please click the little button down there and it says follow. We do appreciate each and every one of those. Special thanks to Thanaroy, who's our last follower. Okay. And as you can see, in 36 and a half hours, we're going to be doing something very special. The Walking Dead, click to continue. Let's see if we can maybe punch up the screen a little bit bigger. Just for laughs. Oh, good Lord, yes. Well, that looks a little bit better. Turn subtitles on just in case. Text on. Story notifications. Okay. Okay. I think that's good for us. Thanaroy again, in 36 hours on Saturday at 8 o'clock in the morning, Central Time. I'm going to be doing 16-hour mini-thon, especially for this. I hope that you all stop in. Please feel free to interact with me in chat. I'm sure the game is going to scare the living daylights out of me. episode status. Okay, we've got them all. Special episodes 400 days coming soon. Okay, I thought we had that, but guess not. Let's jump into it. What happened to the Yeti? I am working on getting an overhead mic stand for the Yeti, and I'm having a little trouble with the shock mount, Daroga. That's the big thing. Until I can get that shock mount set up, I'm off the Yeti right now. So, unfortunately, you can't hear the deep basset tones of my Charlie Brown voice. You'll just have to put up with the little mic. Oh, good Lord, yes. I need help, all the help I can get. Glass desk, you got it. My daughter loves this series, but I've never been a big zombie guy. Scudder, thanks for stopping by, my friend.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Does it really matter?
Nah, not much. You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't.
No worries, Scudder.
We got what looks like a 1091E near Beach 3X285. All cars have to keep on the lookout for 91B here.
I followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case. Like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
Yeah, Dead by Daylight, yeah.
I got
Sounds
a nephew
like a
up
idea.
At UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
Riot in progress. All officers are available for you coming to 17. Rolling calls and dispatches to all locations.
Well, this doesn't sound looking good, does it?
I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming 21.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. not tell him he's got to stop. That's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me. Well, Blabbermouth, let me tell you something.
They caught
the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so. This
What's
other
out?
Time...
Seatbelts don't work too well around here, do they? Oops. Well, how many days will I be out? That's the question. I better believe I'm dead. That's not a good sign. That's an even worse sign.
Why the hell did he have his gun out? Damn it. I need to drag myself out that window.
Yeah, this isn't gonna go well. Make a good crutch.
It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off. Officer? Officer? Officer?
spaceship? What in the hell? Get away from me! Where the hell are you? Don't make me do this!
They still know where to shoot him.
Man.
Out of the frying pan, all right.
His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit. What the hell is this? Are you dead? Hey! Are you dead?
That would have been a question to ask before.
Help! Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
No, this isn't good. Well,
hello, anybody? I wonder if anybody's home. Fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could. No ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg the way it is. Help! Just go for a dip. Somebody! Yell if you can hear me!
I can't go back out there. I wonder if anybody's home.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay?
Thank you.
I'm not an intruder. Or one of them. These people might need more help than I do.
What a wise move, was it? Who'd have thought blood would be that slippery?
Savannah area code, but that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter. This place has been ransacked. Just about anything worthwhile is gone. What's that beeping?
Gotta be the phone.
Three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day.
Looks
Thanks
like
so
Ed
much
didn't
for looking
do
after
so well.
Clementine, and I promise we'll be back
That's why
in
I look
time
like this.
Before your spring break.
Message 2, left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Oh, Jesus.
This?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
You're not my daddy.
No, I'm not. Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think. where the boats are?
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Always on the blood. Looks like the babysitter didn't fare so well. Oh, shikes. Adventures in babysitting. Yes, it is adventures in babysitting.
Hi there.
Did you kill it?
I don't know. I think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
There we go. Get everything back where it belongs, right?
Never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
Do you know what the hell this is?
No idea. So you've seen them then.
You could say that.
I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. Her babysitter. Her parents are out of town.
Let's go with the babysitter. It's probably better
staying
than
put for too long is a mistake.
You know, convicted killer.
What do you want to do?
I.
The monster's coming.
We gotta go. Leave quick. Let's go.
Even Clementine pushing.
As babysitters go, I'd say her parents owe you a tip.
It's all right, man. Reminds me of what I do for any other kid. In your charge, yep. Oh, children in the corn. This ought to be fun.
Hey, Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you, then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's the babysitter.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
Nowhere. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer. He was giving me a ride.
Awful nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there, and we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
I'm looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad, so I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son's right. You're gonna want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
When a horse plops.
My mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
Man has some issues.
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Doc, though.
Doc?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable trait lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm.
I've known a few people like that myself.
Word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
Sure, we'll tag along.
It's a plan, then. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
Hey there, Kenny. Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean, in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
Nah, no kids.
Would've liked one then.
You know. How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Kachi's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's, but... we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
Sometimes that's what it takes.
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government'll start handing out shots and the National Guard'll do its thing.
On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
See ya.
You know how to drive it?
Sure don't. I can give you a hell of a critique of the U.S. Farm Bill, though.
I'm good.
Do you, think this thing will keep them out?
Not yet. I'm planning on coming back through on a fortification pass, if you will. We'll lock this place up good.
Do you, think this thing will keep them out?
Not yet. I'm planning on coming back through on a fortification pass, if you will. We'll lock this place up good. It's just whatever scraps I could find around the property.
Hey there, girls. So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Yeah, my mistake.
We'll all be home soon.
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some. Just...
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Anybody in their right mind would. Families and barbecues and beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
Thank you.
Sean's still working on that fence.
Okay, I gotta find something that's around here. Not gonna let me go in there. What am I missing? That would be something in the barn. Okay, what am I missing?
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two bys to length, that'd sure speed things up. Dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh, I had to shoot.
I could shoot one, maybe, if it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My brother and parents are in Macon, I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
That's what we needed to do. Yeah.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I was on my way out anyway. The timing of all this just happened to be right.
Huh, if there ever is a good time for the supposed apocalypse.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Huh, had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. That's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
No wife. Not anymore. I think she's up in Virginia, maybe.
Sorry to hear it. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
Yeah, I was looking for help in her house.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar, and fast. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're going to have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're going to make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're going to be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
Go! I'll get my gun! Them both.
Look at him. You thought wrong. And now? Please, just go.
Get out and never come back.
Got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Yep, I think we're gonna take it. Okay, everybody, give me a couple minutes. I'm gonna grab another cup of coffee. I'll be right back. In the meantime, a little, bit from Extra Life here, okay?
Eric's disability is very visual. It's you know, with prosthetic legs, and when he gets into a sled, it's even more visual because he takes his legs off and then hops in the sled. The sled hockey helps Eric in a couple ways. This is a competitive sport, and you keep score, you win, you lose. It's true hockey.
Our family was on vacation in the summer of 2000. We'd been away for the whole week up at the lake, swimming and playing. And one time when I was changing his diaper, found two little tiny purple dots on his bottom, which really raised my alarm. Within minutes after that, he had a little tiny pinprick rash all over his chest. The nurse who was there to intake us instantly recognized this rash, and they sent someone right away to call the medevac helicopter.
Eric's condition was changing right in front of our eyes as we were traveling, and so we understood the importance of getting him back here to Rainbow Babies and Children's as quickly as possible.
His blood pressure was low, his heart wasn't working well, his capillaries or his blood vessels were leaking, so he became very edematous.
He had lesions all over him. He had lesions on his face, his hands, his legs.
4 hours later, this terrible rash, no blood pressure, and your organs literally completely shutting down.
We were able to stabilize him in terms of maintaining heart rate, keeping blood flow, but we could not stop the progression of the blood clotting.
The next week or so is just a blur of him being in the intensive care and being sedated and being on a respirator and them telling us all these medical terms of everything that was wrong and all the fears that there were and the low blood pressure and not knowing hour to hour or day to day if he would even survive.
The hardest part was the amputation.
And the surgeon came back and sat down next to me and held my hand and said, then we're gonna have to amputate both of Eric's legs.
And I actually, you know, had to sign the form for them to take his legs. The good thing is that's what made him better. That once they amputated, then everything turned around.
And the next day, when Eric woke up to see our little boy back, to see him smile and laugh and play, there was never any looking back from that point on.
Eric taking his first steps in his prosthetic legs are probably, that's the reason we work here. He went upstairs when he called him his bendy knees, you know, and he could go up a step and bend. And, you know, his mom called me and said, you know, he went up a stair.
You know, when I see Eric now, I think he's a miracle. He really surpassed any expectations from when he first came into the hospital.
And for him to come back and to be the vibrant kid who can actually play golf a lot better than I can is totally a true miracle.
And I think his determination and strength is why he's here.
Eric doesn't let anything slow him down. He wants to do everything that he can, and even the things that he can't.
I don't give up because it'll never make it better.
People ask me, how can you go back to that hospital where all those terrible things happened to you? And they don't understand what a wonderful relationship that we established with all those caregivers at Rainbow Babies and Children's. And those people really legitimately cared about our son and about us. You never know when you're gonna need a specialty hospital. And you just think you're never gonna need it. They make a real difference in lives of children and families every day.
You know, we can't thank the Children's Miracle Network enough for their support of Rainbow Babies and Children's Hospital and all the children's hospitals across America.
Children's Miracle Network provide funds to hospitals that regular hospitals would never have access to.
What's more important than the care of children? What's more important than the care of children when they're at their sickest or at their lowest point? Children's Hospital are a safety net for so many families across this country, that the Children's Miracle Network is a part of the support that, quite frankly, we need day in and day out to take care of these important kids and their wonderful families.
I like to help the hospital because they saved my life, and I want to help to save others.
And now, the worst streamer on the internet, Battery H.
Hey, thank you, Johnny Announcer. We're going to push the stream link for Extra Life one more time here, just so that you can all see it. We're going to get back in the game. We've raised $470 to date of my $1,337 goal, raising money for Children's Hospital of New Orleans, as you see flashing all over the screen all the time here. Okay, let's do this. Let's get back into the game. See what happens here tonight. That doesn't sound good.
Well, this is as far as we're going.
And it's far enough.
You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
I'd say he's not friendly. Oh crap, the whole town are not friendly.
Retract!
Always nice to find
a
shooter.
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
She's not wrong. They took a risk.
Yes, we did.
And we appreciate it. Now let's settle down.
Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten.
Shut up. We gotta throw him out or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle him.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Everyone chill the fuck out! Nobody's doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here. And none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Please stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened. She's not some snot-nosed toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
Fuck you and her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
It's a little boy. I think we can handle him.
A little boy? He'll be an uncontrollable man-eater.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now.
No, you don't touch that boy. You don't touch anybody. I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on. You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here.
Jesus!
Come inside.
Get
away from her, you son of a bitch!
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in! Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
I did try to get him to calm down.
Can it, asshole? It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
We'll get in there somehow.
Thank you so much.
We even gotta help the assholes. Pills.
Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
Then I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
She ain't happy about being supplanted. Okay, let's see if I find some stuff here.
It's not damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted. Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down. Central High Tech State. Papers a week old. Feels like years.
I think behind the counter there would be...
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon. Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They're gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Kat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead. Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess.
But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves over
We him. Killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happen. We didn't make a choice that killed Sean. You think you do when you look back on it. But in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Try to let it go.
Yep. Oh boy, it's heavy in here. If he goes apeshit and starts chewing on people, I will be very upset. But this is a Telltale game, so you can almost count on it.
Just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
It's all melted our damnedest. It's all melted now.
There's got to be.
It's not much, but here. For the boy.
Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
I'll see about that. Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job. Well, sit tight.
Okay.
It's not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. Damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted. How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again, and I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day.
Oh.
Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky.
Yes, I understand this.
I work up at UGA. Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead.
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this. What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
He's got a temper.
Ah, fuck you!
Yeah, he doesn't mean it.
It's just that...
Yeah?
Never mind. I'm sure he's a good guy.
He is. He just has his issues. Where's her mom?
Savannah. I think.
Oh, you guys aren't together.
Oh, No, I'm not her dad. I found her in a house when getting out of Atlanta. She'd been surviving by herself. I think the girl's parents didn't make it.
Oh.
I heard an answering message. They were in Savannah. She was home with a sitter. It wasn't good.
Well, she's lucky to have you. I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good. It's not much, but here.
You sure?
Yeah. You're under quite a bit of stress.
Thanks. That's, really sweet.
Don't mention it.
Alive inside. Jesus Christ. Oh, man. And Dad pulled him out into the street just in case.
Can't think about them in here. There's a photo over there.
Find anything?
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
The world is ending out there. Who cares who I am?
If you don't think people will find any reason to turn on you, especially when the shit hits the fan, you're insane.
Whatever.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
What's that?
This was my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that. Clear this door for when we find the keys. I ought to clear a path to opening that door. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure.
This isn't
Here
going
we
to
go.
End well, is
Put
it?
Put your fingers in the drawers. Things have been scary, huh?
Yeah. It's not good. I don't know why everyone is crazy.
Neither do I, Clementine. Nobody does, I don't think.
I bet my dad does.
Okay, here we go.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
You didn't answer my question.
All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
Because they're dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You didn't know.
I'm just sorry for being mean.
Look, my family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I'm not a bad guy, okay? Things happened, and we didn't talk much after that.
My parents don't talk to me when I get in trouble.
I can relate. Are you okay?
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
I'll find you a bandage. There's a band-aid in there, I bet.
Oh, good.
I saw a first aid kit around here somewheres.
And I'm not there.
They'll track us down. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay? Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
For that thing in here someplace. It's the remote to my dad's TV.
Probably not a good idea.
That's what I figured. That's the door to the pharmacy. We should be able to find pills for Larry in there. It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry.
Mom and Dad gonna have the keys. I have a bad feeling about that. Oh, man.
head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay.
Let's see if I can figure out what's going on here.
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
It's complicated. Sometimes things happen, or you do things and you can't explain them. Let's head back to the others. First aid kit. Luckily, there's nothing I need in here.
Where he drug him out, but apparently I cannot.
Hey.
I'm gonna get back to him.
Sounds good.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
This is Glenn, and I'm kinda in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie, or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies, and you got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do.
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look. Batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Wow. Okay. She's gonna be a huge help in the zombie apocalypse.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
Not right now.
All right, let me know if you want to.
No, I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead car.
Can I not access my... Thinking I should be able to pull the battery out of my,
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Of modern,
As the unknown continues to spread unchecked, the estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... my producer's telling me we have to get off the air.
Steve.
WABE wishes you and your loved one... God bless you all.
Don't think it ended well for WABE.
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but
you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That radio sign-off didn't sound too good. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You don't have to be. It's traumatic.
I'm sure some people got out. Maybe they're all being rescued. Then again, maybe not.
How are we doing?
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Okay. Left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here. Did you guys try to get in there and get weapons?
I did, but it was too risky. And then a bunch of guys showed up and they tried.
And what happened?
I think they're most of who you see wandering around out there.
It's a combination lock. Man, that's a hasty fortification job over there.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Look at the one trapped over. Oh, shit.
What? Do you know that guy?
He could be a drugstore employee.
So you're saying he might have the pharmacy keys?
I'm saying he might have the pharmacy keys.
I don't know. Could be anybody, you know? They start rotting and get all chewed up.
Shut up, Doc. Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
It would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find. Let's head back inside.
Okay.
Okay, folks, it's 9:08, and unfortunately, I'm going to have to call it here for the evening. I don't know if it'll let me save it or not. I hope so. My last autosave was. That's the problem. Well. Well, folks, I'm afraid that is going to have to be it, so we're just going to have to hope. And I will see you all tomorrow evening at 7:30 Central Time. Thanks, everybody, for coming out. Scouter, for swinging by. Daroga, thank you for coming in. We're going to pick up with The Walking Dead tomorrow on day two. Hope to see you all then. Have a great night. And remember, please consider a donation to Extra Life. We're raising money for Children's Hospital of New Orleans. We've got a 36, less than 36 hours, about 34 and a half hours till Saturday morning, 8 o'clock. I'll be doing a 16-hour mini-thon as a part of the 100 Days of Gaming, day two tomorrow night. Hope to see you then.
If you've enjoyed the stream, despite the awful host, please consider a donation to Extra Life. Thank you for watching. Thank you.